Hello and welcome to this video about using the standardized data and metadata exchange format with an Open SDG platform. In this video, Rwanda, Kyrgyzstan, and Kazakhstan will answer some questions about their experience of using SDMX as the data input format for their Open SDG platforms. Why were you interested in SDMX support for your Open SDG platform?
So we were looking how we can improve and standardize data and metadata collected from our national statistical system, NSS, and how we can disseminate them with the overarching objective of making data usage easier and maintaining data quality.
Международный стандарт обмена данными достаточно давно используется для публикации, обмена данными многими странами и международными организациями. К примеру, Казахстан осуществляет передачу определенного набора показателей с помощью формата SDMX в рамках Евразийского экономического союза. В целом, на уровне нашего бюро была заинтересованность во внедрении данного формата для обмена данными в других отраслях. Поэтому, когда появилась такая возможность при разработке национальной платформы отчетности для ЦУР, мы были рады тому, что переход на новый формат позволит упростить процесс обмена нашими национальными данными на региональных и глобальных уровнях.
There are a few reasons why we have decided to use SDMX for our SDG data and for our national Open SDG platform. First, the goal of SDMX is to create common standards for the exchange of statistical data and metadata. So this allows us to gain efficiency and avoid duplication in our work. Second, the SDG data in the SDMX format can be easily uploaded to the Open SDG platform and another platform. There is no need to further convention, as SDMX supports multilingualism, it's easy to maintain interfaces in multiple languages. So, for example, Kyrgyzstan Open SDG platform today is available in English and Russian languages, and Kyrgyz languages is for the coming. The uniform ADSD structure allow users to read and correctly interpret data from any sources as national, regional, and global.
How did you go about mapping your data to SDMX?
Good. So the first step, what we did, we created the Excel of the data of the SDG data we had, I mean the available data. And then after creating the SDG Excel file, so that file, it has the description of each indicator. We specify if indicator is global or local indicator, and the data and the series number, the unity, all those things were available in the Excel file. So after getting the Excel file, now we jump to the next step, the second step of converting out by using the DSD customized to get the DSD the SDMX format.
В настоящее время Казахстан располагает данными по глобальным и национальным показателям в формате SDMX, структура которых была разработана в соответствии с руководством ООН по настройке глобальной структуры данных для индикаторов ЦУР. Благодаря поддержке Брока Фаннинга из компании КОД и коллег из Всемирного банка мы смогли перевести наши данные из формата Excel в формат SDMX, структурировать их описание, особенно в части дезагрегации данных.
We use only two tools. First is OECD SDMX Matrix Generator. It's used to edit, update Kyrgyzstan SDG DSD. This tool is a simple Excel sheet, includes harmonized concept and attributes, easy to map, reuse in systems. Matrix generator creates new DSD structure with extended code list. And the second tool is Eurostat SDMX converter. This tool is used to create SDMX ML files. For it, first SDG data in an Excel file is mapped to the SDG DSD. The mappings are saved as a working sheets in the files. Then the Excel file is processed with the SDMX converter and the converter into SDMX. Then last, the SDMX ML files is outputted and validated against the DSD with any error listed.
What lessons did you learn when implementing SDMX with your Open SDG platform?
The first lesson we get from this, SDMX reduces our time. Secondly, it helped us to specify if the indicator is local or if the indicator is global. The third that I can't miss, we collect the indicator with a lot of descriptions, because some of the indicators, we are considering them as proxies. So it was not easy to use those to capture those indicators in Excel. But now in SDMX, it allows us to capture all those descriptions. You see, now SDMX is easier and friendly to be used for reporting the SDGs indicators.
Во-первых, нелегко было осуществлять коммуникацию. Вся работа с экспертами проходила в формате онлайн из-за существующих ограничений, к сожалению. Во-вторых, очень много технических деталей, в которых простому статистику сложно разобраться. Скорее всего, должна быть совместная работа статистиков и IT-специалистов. В-третьих, следует отметить, что нужно хорошо понимать уровень детализации показателей, чтобы правильно структурировать данные. Это был один из самых сложных моментов подготовки данных для конвертации в SDMX. И, наконец, последнее. Очень радует, что после того, как вы вложили столько усилий, мы вложили в этот процесс, обновление данных не требует значительных затрат по времени.
What we have learned using and implementing SDMX is first, both technical and statistical experts need to be involved to the process. There is a request for a human capacity with understanding data and data structure. There is a request to have a regular extent support, can be remote support of course, but it can help to create a sustainable capacity within organization. There is a request to implement SDMX, and within the implementing SDMX, there is a request to give investment into work. It's like trainings and another communications. But this investment pays off with the benefits of SDMX brings.
What are your planned next steps for SDMX and Open SDG?
Yeah, we are planning a lot of things because you see this is a step we started. Rwanda adopted the SDGs indicator, Rwanda domesticated the SDGs indicators, and we set the process of reporting them. So it's a continuous journey. So we want to continue to report our SDGs indicators, but by changing the way that we reported them before. So we want to continue to report the SDGs by using SDMX as we get the trainings on it, by updating the existing indicators, because we have around 150 indicators reported now. So we want to maximize the number reported as we collect the indicator from the NSS members. Secondly, we managed to report some few indicators on SDG Lab. So we wish to use this SDMX to increase the number of SDGs indicator we reported on SDG Lab. So briefly, I can say those two things, the main things, because first we want to increase the number on SDG Lab, Secondly, we want to continue to report the indicators, the new ones, and even updating the existing ones. Thank you. Over.
Как мы знаем, в ближайшем будущем команда Open SDG должна добавить функциональность, позволяющую выводить данные SDMX на платформу, с платформ. То есть, как только эта функция станет доступной, мы бы хотели добавить ее и в нашу национальную платформу PADSUR, чтобы позволить, чтобы пользователи могли получить доступ к данным ЦУР по Казахстану в формате SDMX непосредственно самой платформы.
Next step is implementing SDMX API as .start or another platforms, and it can make easier data and metadata management. Also, there is a plan to implement SDMX standards for another field of statistics as well.
Thank you for watching this video about using SDMX with OpenSDG. This video, along with others, can be found on YouTube by searching for OpenSDG, and more information about OpenSDG can be found at open-sdg.org.